Hello everyone. The topic which we are going to discuss about today is Python technology. Okay, so as a prerequisite to this particular course, you don't need any prior knowledge about any programming language. Okay, if you have knowledge about some other programming language, it will be easier for you to understand. But it is okay even you don't have any idea about any programming language. It's good. There is no issue for that. Okay. So pretty much I'm going to cover from the beginning. So at the end of this course, you'll be able to write a programs with the help of strings or variable or different kind of data types and oops and all the parameters actually. Okay, so what are the prerequisites? As I said, there is no need any prior knowledge. Okay, and we'll go step by step. The first thing what you need is install Python. Okay, and second is IDE. And third, what we're gonna see. So, doesn't matter whatever the programming language is. There are some basic stuff which you need to know before you proceeding into the complex stuff. Okay. So here, once we enter into the Python, so I have a Python installed in my machine and I have IDE. What else I need to do? The first thing which we need to see as well as math functionality, and following that string, and then logical and data structure. That's the important thing, data structure. And what else? So the looping. Okay, so and how to create functions in Python, and the major important thing is oops concept. Okay, so we are going to discuss about each and everything in a separate topic. Okay, so as a first step, what we are going to do is we are going to install Python. So how do we do that? Okay, so go to your browser and type Python download. It will take you to the Python downloads link. Go to the link. Here you have a hyperlink called download Python 3.7.0. it doesn't matter, maybe you might have some additional version also. So just download what is the latest version which is available in the download list. Okay, just download this. So it will take up some time. So since I have downloaded the setup file already, so I'm not going to download it again. So where it is? Okay, software and development and Python, I have the setup. Okay, so how are we going to install it? Okay, just double click the exe file and click run. Okay, the reason why it is showing modify, repair, and install, I already installed Python in my machine. Okay, so that is the reason it is showing up. Okay, so what basically you need to do is when the launch page appeared in your screen, okay, you don't have much things to do. Okay, you just simply click next and finish. But as a first step, you need to click a checkbox which is showing in the first pop-up page. That means your Python has to be added into your machine environmental variable. So that will be, so you can access Python from any location in your local machine. Okay. Okay, let me show you how it is done. Okay, so once you double click the exe file, you'll pop up with a security warning. So do you want to install? Just click run, and the next pop-up screen, you'll have the installation instruction. This is what I'm talking about. Add Python 3.6 to your path. Since you're downloading 3.7, it will be different for each and different versions. Okay, make sure you add Python 3.6 to the path. Okay, and then click next and ace, and go up to the end of the process, and finally the setup was successfully installed on your machine. Okay, so okay, how do I know whether I'm able to access all the Python from all our location? I mean all our location, the sense means in your local machine. Okay, go to the command prompt. So go to any drive and just check whether Python version. If you got some proper response, that means the Python is installed in your machine and it will be accessible for all the locations. Okay, so it's taking a while. Oh, come on. Okay, it is showing on. Okay, my bad. Wait, done. Version. See, in my local I installed Python 3.7 and I'm able to access from my D drive. Let me try from some other drive. So I'm gonna try Python version. See, it is accessible all the places. Okay, so this is how we need to install the Python setup in your local machine. In the next video we'll discuss about, so how are we going to start the coding, what IDE I'm going to use it. Okay, so we'll discuss in the next video. Thank you guys.